The nation's hospitals are bracing for even tougher times ahead, with the Omicron wave expected to wipe out many more medical staff. To try to get around the worker shortages, the federal government has a new plan to keep doctors on the job, even if they're infected with the virus.
As the virus spreads at lightning speed, the Omicron variant is slowing down critical services.
We've got many thousands of healthcare workers, doctors, nurses and other workers off work themselves.
COVID patient numbers are climbing too. There were 4,643 people in hospital today, 389 in ICU, with 126 on ventilators.
It's really a perfect storm that's led to elective surgery closures across most of the country.
Chantelle Homan was a nurse at an aged care home in Victoria, but quit under the pressure.
Nursing's not nursing anymore. Our workload now makes me want to resign as a nurse altogether.
We know doctors and nurses are exhausted. We know hospitals are overwhelmed, but we haven't heard anything from Scott Morrison.
The government today announced a lifeline for healthcare workers, providing $24 million to expand telehealth services, allowing COVID-positive patients to access medical treatment from home. It also means specialists forced into isolation can still work and provide medical care over the phone. The money will also help fund an additional 11 million masks and 4 million gloves for GPs and pharmacists, but doctors will have to find their own rapid tests.
We're working with suppliers to ensure that there's priority direct from the suppliers and through other sources for general practices.
With hopes the virus peak is nearing, health experts say reinfection is still possible and catching Omicron doesn't protect you from Delta.
We are still seeing people with Delta infections, and so clearly Omicron, while it might push the numbers of Delta down in the community, it's not necessarily going to replace it.
Some more relief is expected this week. The government is expanding its pandemic leave payments, so anyone in isolation or caring for someone with COVID will be eligible for up to $750 a week. The change comes into effect from Tuesday. Rachel Baxter, Nine News.